first thought, best thought sort of scenarios, and then just again codifying, and then if they hate it, deleting it, making another one, deleting it, making another one, with the same tools until you like break out of habit. And then we did 3 memory solos. That's one of the ways that I teach the memory solos. Another way is coming into the space, teaching something really fast, leaving, coming back. Maybe people see me come back or not. And also just sort of like cutting into people's like practice, like really abruptly. I like doing that with dancers because it, first of all, it gets us out of our own heads. And then later we codify, we clean, we delete things. Like if I'm like, oh Seb, like I really like this part of your memory solo, let's cut this part, it's not fitting into the work, like, or like, can you make that travel? Like then it starts to like inform composition. But also I just think it's such a nice way to just like see where stuff goes. And again, what resonates, like did all of the dancers remember this one thing and why? Did everyone forget this one thing and why? Yeah, and I wrote this down right before I came in, but the piece that I've made on the Cornish cast it's called Wasteland, and it's actually a piece about what happens after you surrender to forces that are greater than you, specifically natural forces, specifically the body. Mm-hmm. What happens when you surrender to the body, and all of the space that's beyond that moment of surrender. So creating was really important to actually practice that in the process, like shedding, breaking down, deleting, giving in, like coming up against something, going through it anyway. Like it's part of building the work. It's not just like here's a bunch of phrases that I think are pretty and you're good at. Like you have to have like a deep physical vested experience in order for the